Welcome to another episode of Behind the Science on Location. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. Proteins carry out numerous major biological functions inside the body, like growth, development, and cell signaling, to name a few. Many proteins interact with each other, forming a system that carries out complex functions. Just like a gold medal team, our body is on its A game when all of the protein players are working together in perfect harmony. Therefore, understanding how they interact and what is the resulting effect of the protein-protein interaction is useful to understand these biological processes. So in this episode of Behind the Science, let's dive into the importance of protein-protein interactions and a technique used to analyze them. So I'm here at the University of Texas at Dallas, and it's hot out here. So I'm gonna go in to meet some cool scientists, and y'all can come too. Hi, Prit, I'm so glad that I found you.
Hi there, I'm good. I'm just hiding in my room, working on my data.
Well, that's okay, because I actually had a question for you.
Yes.
I am worried that my proteins are not being good team players, and I hear you're doing some work on protein-protein interaction.
That's exactly what I'm doing. So all the proteins in our body need to work together, communicate, and interact for processes like growth and repair to occur. Kind of like a soccer team, all the players need to work together to achieve one goal, and when they don't, that's when you lose the match, or that's when in our body we have stuff like disease that happen. So protein-protein interaction analysis is really important because it gives us useful information like where they bind, how many of them bind, how strongly they interact, and what the effect of their interaction is.
So can you tell me how you do this work and what instrumentation you use?
Absolutely. So I'm working on an instrumentation called SEC-MALS. Okay. It is composed of two components, size-exclusion chromatography, which is SEC. In this, we have our separation chromatography system where larger proteins are separated first and then smaller proteins are separated. And then once it separates, it goes into this light scattering detector, which is the MALS or the multi-angle light scattering. And then over here, larger proteins or protein complexes scatter more light than smaller proteins. That's basically the principle of this method. And on the bottom, we have another instrument that measures refractive index, and that gives us concentration.
Interesting. So I think I caught you when you were doing some data processing.
Yes.
Could we go to a whiteboard and take a look at that data?
Absolutely. Here is a schematic of two proteins, A and B. When they interact, they form a larger complex, AB, which scatter more light than just A. Processing this data gives us the molecular weights on the secondary y-axis. Based on the observed molecular weight, we can compare it to the theoretical molecular weight and make conclusions whether 1A binds to 1B or 2B or 3Bs.
So how versatile is this technique compared to other techniques that look at protein-protein interaction?
This technique is really versatile, and most importantly, it's very simple. We just design our experiment and the machine does everything for us, and then we can just analyze the data. So in terms of simplicity of design, we can design experiments where we have different concentrations of proteins that we can look at, or do a titration where we can have one protein constant and just titrate the other one. In terms of versatility, it's really versatile because not just looking at proteins, we can look at nucleic acids, carbohydrates, as well as small molecules. And we can not only work with aqueous buffers like this one, but we can also use organic solvents.
Well, I'm a team player, so how about you coach me and let's go see all these other proteins and how they interact.
Sure, let's do it.
My coach has always told me to be a team player. Well, proteins need to be as well, and understanding these interactions is critical to bodily success. We know how hard it is to behave all the time. So at least when it comes to protein-protein interaction, we have a tool such as SEC-MALS to visualize and quantify proteins that interact with each other. To find out more about the work the Darcy Lab is doing, check out the link below. And for a new Waters application note on the topic, access it here. And join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science on Location.